Faitape is the administrative and economic center of the island. It's a dynamic small town in the image of the rest of the island, where business activity is largely dominated by tourism. When the shuttle boat leaves you on Faitape Dock, rental cars reserved in advance await you, and taxis sent by the hotels pick up their clients. The municipal services are located at the entry to the town. Then one finds the Bank of Polynesi and represents Societe Generale, the post office, the gendarmerie in the large White House, the Air Tahiti ticketing desk and the quay in Faitape, as well as large number of boutiques directly related to the tourism industry, several rent-a-car companies, courier boutiques in the premises built in local style, jewelry stores with their fine presentations of the Tahitian black pearl, a colorful crafts industry center where visitors are warmly welcomed, a bakery shop for those who are fond of pastries, the Chin Lee store just a few steps away from the Protestant temple and which by far is the store with the largest selection of goods, and finally, the Maison de la Presse, which besides magazines offers a wide range of souvenirs. Under the impulsion of Robert Vann, the emperor of the Tahitian black pearl, the beautiful jewelry store has been created in Bora Bora. The magic of this jewel has caused women to dream throughout the world, finds new dimensions here that reinforces the charm, beauty, and mystery of the island which bears its name so well. The dynamism of Bora Bora is most evident during the month of July. Bora Bora commemorates the taking of Bastille with a sumptuous festival known locally as Heiva, and which continues unabated for several weeks. Gaston Tansong, the mayor of Bora Bora, has upped the efforts of his municipality by increasing the colors and rhythms of these festivities to demonstrate that his island belongs within the French Republic as a whole. He quite simply granted us an interview, which we are pleased to present to you. Your Honor, if you allow me, I would like to firstly send a message to my population to thank them for the confidence they have demonstrated towards my municipal council and myself for this new six-year mandate. To you who have come from far away, from all corners of the earth, please allow me to welcome you to this island of Bora Bora, lost in the middle of the Pacific, by saying Maeva. I would also like to tell you that our wish and our daily struggle is to ensure that you can live in harmony amongst our population in the midst of its traditions, its simplicity, its culture, language, its songs and dances. The Heiva festivities is the best time for this rendezvous. Every day in the hotels, you will see Polynesians of Bora Bora as they express themselves in full simplicity with their heart and their thoughts. I would like to end this message by wishing you a happy stay among us. May you return home with the finest memories of this island, the most beautiful pictures, and the very best impressions you felt upon diving into this transparent water. Above all, take our hearts back home with you. Maruru. In Polynesia, the local districts represent the last link in the chain between the population and the French state and territorial services. In educational matters, there are not less than six establishments providing education to the young people of Bora Bora. If the reserves of the drinking water come from the artesian wells or catchment points taken directly in the rivers in Tahiti and the High Islands, here in Bora Bora, it was necessary to turn towards the creation of a desalinization unit.
L'eau de mer puisse passer au travers de ce cylindre et ici on récupère finalement l'eau potable.
This unit is under management of the municipality and provides fresh water for the entire population. Insofar as the treatment of wastewater is concerned, the local municipality of Bora Bora is a model. In fact, it was on this island that the true first wastewater treatment process was undertaken. The project, financed to a large extent by the European Community, puts on us the wish of the town councillors to protect the environment they rightly consider as being the very basis of the development of the tourist industry on the island. During the Heiva festivities, a large number of stands are set up on the quay in Faitape where visitors can find food and drink, but also an occasion to play games. Top 8 is a space completely dedicated to celebration, and the Outrigger canoe races are a high point of the day. When night falls, the celebration continues with large competitions of traditional singing and dancing that brings together the inhabitants of all the villages of the island. Weeks in advance, the participants prepare their sumptuous costumes and rehearse without respite their singing and choreography. People come in ever-increasing numbers, often from far away, to participate in these evening and authentic folklore that literally enchants the spectators. Bor Bor has accommodated many artists. Many seem to have found the way to their own development here. Such is the case of Jean Masson, who first arrived in 1936. He settled in Bora Bora and founded a family. His luminous works restored the serene happiness of Polynesia. Emmanuel Masson, his son, follows a career in painting much as did his father. His children and his Tahitian wife maintain with great care the family lands and the small marae that bears witness to the long history of family roots on the side of the mother, Rosine, daughter of a distinguished local chief. In just a few years, tourist development has considerably changed the south side of Bora Bora. Numerous visitor-oriented establishments have opened their doors. For the art enthusiasts, Alan and Linda's gallery overflow the objects and paintings of local artists that represent the island. The gallery Gauguin also merits a visit for the pleasures offered for both the eyes and the palate. For the finicky gourmets, there are some marvelous restaurants to visit. The most famous of them all is, without question, Bloody Mary's. With its ample dock, guests can arrive by either land or sea. Besides its appetizing menu, the restaurant's guest register is filled with the names of celebrities who have come to try the establishment.